Welcome to another brief topic by the name Delegated Legislation. Introduction. The rules, Delegated Legislation are rules and regulations that are made by other competent bodies other than the Parliament. So these are the rules. They are rules which are created in a state made by other competent bodies rather than the Parliament. They are also referred to as indirect registration or subordinate registration or subsidiary registration. For instance, the encompasses the rules made by cabinet secretaries, also known as ministers. They form the basis of the delegated registration. Another, we have various types of delegated registration. One of them is statutory instrument. Other, they are provisional orders. Other, they are bylaws or these are rules made by county governments or states, order in council, special and emergency orders, or court decision or court orders. We have the various advantages of delegated registration. One of them is that they save time. Subsidiary registration saves time for Parliament by assisting Parliament in making law, hence allowing Parliament to concentrate on matters of general public. So, delegated registration or subordinate registration come to rescue Parliament from the limited time which the Parliament is given. So it rescue Parliament in making some registration, allowing Parliament to concentrate with other affairs of general public, emergency. Delegated registration cover urgent matters since they are not debated because Parliament is always in session, because Parliament is not always in session. For instance, in terms of emergency, for instance, when COVID pandemic emerged into the world, before Parliament could table down the bill and pass all the procedural which the bill should pass before it becomes a rule, it could take a long period of time. So by delegated registration, we were able to come with urgent rules which could be able to counter the COVID-19 pandemic, like restricting the flight from other countries from coming into our countries. So we depend largely on delegated registration in emergency, flexible. Its registration are flexible, hence they can be modified from time to time if found non-practical in certain areas. They are flexible because they do not follow a lot of legal formalities to be formed. So they do not utilize a lot of resources compared to the Act of Parliament. They are technical matters. They allow technical matters to be covered by expertise to deal the rule, hence seems to be effective rather than those rules made by Parliament. So the delegated registration, sometimes if health sector is delegated with certain responsibility, it involves experts in the health sector, so they are effective and practical in nature. Future problems. Subordinate registration deals with future problems and new challenges, since they can be easily amended and scrubbed off, since they do not follow a lot of procedural formalities. Yeah, they can deal with future problems, since they can be changed, modified from time to time. Also, the delegates registration, sometimes they have some defect. One of them is legal omission. Sometimes cabinet secretaries or ministers are given mandate to make rules on matter of general public, which is a constitutional mandate given to Parliament, since they are direct representation of general public. So there is some legal omission when cabinet secretaries or ministers are given mandate to make rules on matter of general public. For instance, the cessation of movement, which was implemented during the pandemic. So the ministers or cabinet secretaries could be offered with a mandate or with in creating rules that were offering the cessation of movement from place to place or from a certain area to a certain area, which is an affair, which is a public affair. So by giving that mandate to deal with the rule affecting the general public, though they are not the direct representation of the people, since most probably they are appointed in country which adopt the presidential system, they are appointed by the president and the country, but they are also vetted by the parliament. But in the countries which they uphold the parliamentary system, they are appointed by the prime minister They are also vetted by the parliament. So they are not the direct representation of the people, since they are not directly elected by the people. So they are non-democratic in nature. Since some personal bodies delegated some power to make registration, though not the representative of general public, therefore not accountable if they make any undesirable rule. For instance, in finance sector and treasury sector, if they are mandated to in creation of treasury bills or rules which involve the delegation of funds, so they can make rules which favor them. Since they are not accountable to anybody, they are not accountable to citizens, so they only accountable to their bosses. So if they are they make undesirable rules to the citizens, they are not accountable to citizens. Inadequate supervision. Sometimes delegated legislation lack adequate supervision from parliament, since the law are passed within very limited time for parliament to supervise. So in terms of delegated legislation, parliament is faced by a lot of work and a lot of background of bills. So sometimes it will fail to supervise fully the delegated legislation. So inadequate publicity. Law made by parliament are highly publicized compared to delegated legislation. For instance, I like using this example. When we experienced pandemic, we used a lot of delegated registration. For instance, in order to put the cessation of movement from a certain country to another or a certain state to another, there was not high publicity or publicizing in the country's gazette that there will be cessation of movement. It was done without a lot of publicity. You woke up, oh, you cannot move from this state to this state because they have been close to come to counter the spread of the pandemic. So abusive rule, there is a possibility of abusive rule. For instance, due to lack of enough supervision from parliament, give a higher chance of indirect law being abusive by the body delegated to make the rule. So these bodies, since they do not receive a lot of supervision by the parliament, which is the direct representation of the people, can be biased in nature and make laws which do not act in favor of the citizens. So there is high chance of emergence of rules which are abusive to citizens. So I think that marks the end of our topic. Thank you for watching. Kindly remember to subscribe and comment about the video. Thank you.